Hello internet and welcome back to the most inquisitive channel on YouTube, Life's Biggest Questions, that digital cosmic ley line where all alternative realities and hypothetical shifts in time come to a headway in a convenient welcoming foyer. What's going on guys? As per usual, I'll be your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch, as we pull some strings on the geopolitical scale, rise up as a rogue nation hell-bent on ushering in the apocalypse itself, before instantly regretting that decision when realising how much cool stuff we're going to miss out on, as we curiously ask the question, what if the world ended in 2050? Roll the clip. Now, it's safe to say that this video is going to be quite the buzzkillington, as it will slowly dawn on you that humanity is merely half a century away from some of the coolest, dopest, and other positive adjectives that science and technology has to offer. Really, in the latter half of the 21st century, science fiction is set to walk proudly into the realm of science fact, giving way to a myriad of advancements in the fields of medicine, industry, economics, retail, and space exploration. For decades, we've dreamt of machines that can replicate a perfect beef Wellington with the mere push of a button from Captain Jean Luc Picard, or individual taste depending, tea, Earl Grey, hot. But sorry folks, show's over, the world has regretfully ended in 2050. Well, let's take a look at what we could have won. Before we do that though, you know how it is by now. Question is, if you're a fan of this video, futurism, the technological advancement of the human race, or just life's biggest questions in general, then please demonstrate your duty as a galactic citizen, hit that thumbs up button and show us some love in the comments section down below. If you'd like to get in touch with myself or the wider creative team here at LBQ, then be sure to take a look at the info box below. On with the show. Alright, so the year is 2050, the planet has seen a mammoth shift in the way that the average human lives their life. Never before has the planet been so interconnected, ushering in a new age of bright, peaceful coexistence as mankind takes their first baby steps into the galaxy as a spacefaring species. Unfortunately though, despite that, we've either been hit by an extinction level event-sized asteroid, killed each other in a barbaric thermonuclear war, or been completely eradicated by a highly advanced alien civilization. We were so close, and yet so far. However, before we take a look at all the things we're going to miss out on, let's take a brief look at the landmarks we've achieved between 2018 and 2050. The 2020s were a tumultuous period for the human race. For the Western world, the Trump administration left behind one hell of a mess on the geopolitical scale, yet it was down to the hard-working young generations to piece Humpty Dumpty back together again. In the early 20s, the fallout of the Trump administration had chased China's tail into the Asian Pacific as the two global superpowers' constant power shift destabilized the region, shaking up the global economy and stretching the US-China relations to near breaking point. Eventually, China won out and displaced the United States as the leading global superpower. However, it left time for a complete reshape of global politics, led now by the emerging Generation X, driven by a backlash against the Trump administration and baby boomers in general. Employees gained more rights, freedoms, and flexibility in the workplace as technology caught up with the demands of a changing economy. By the late 2020s, human-like AI became a reality, with the vast majority of computing power routinely passing the Turing test, leading the way to an age of technological enlightenment. The 2030s were another incredibly testing decade for the planet, but a brave new endeavor into our solar system. This was spurred on by the discovery of definitive evidence of life beyond Earth, captured by the highly advanced high-definition space telescope between the 2030s and 2040s. An immediate boost for space exploration funding surged across the planet, justifying the planned crewed settlements to Mars and the Moon. By the late 2030s, crewed missions to the moon of Phobos were commonplace, with regular mining operations occurring across the main asteroid belt. By the 2040s, the space industry would be the leading economic powerhouse of the planet, giving rise to the world's first trillionaire. China's space program rivaled that of NASA as the emerging spacefaring nations raced to establish themselves permanently in a proximity to Earth, the Moon, and Mars. Meanwhile, the global population would reach 9 billion as humanity enjoyed the benefits of a technologically advanced medical system. The average person would slowly become intimately merged with machines, giving rise to a never-before-seen style of living. And that's when the bubble burst, and we get to the end of the line, 2050. game over, sadly. But for the sake of brevity, let's say that this is, in actual fact, the point where the defining era of our species would begin. By 2050, humanity would be at a crossroads, a world of contrasts and paradoxes. On the one hand, the runaway train of science and technology would continue to advance into a brave new world, giving near immediate solutions to emerging crises and challenges. On the other hand, that same technology would be the reason that the world was so frightening, unpredictable, and chaotic than ever before. Humanity would stand at the precipice of two paths, a choice that would determine our future for centuries to come. Survival or destruction, prosperity or collapse. Let's say that the world didn't end in 2050 and we chose the path of mutual survival and prosperity. As we put aside our differences and the latter half of the 21st century came to a close, our species would step into an emerging era of post-scarcity and resource-based economies. We would witness the rapid growth of transhumanism, an entirely new version of the human being. Our purpose in this solar system would be to explore it with a wealth of technologies and resources at our disposal. Major developments in space travel would mark the defining purpose of our place in the universe, as finally the answer to that one big question would get closer than ever before. Well, in that case then, let's sincerely hope that the world doesn't end in 2050. Unfortunately folks, that's all we've got time for in today's video. Cheers for sticking around all the way to the end. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure to hit that subscribe bell and share it on with your nearest and dearest. If you'd like to continue on with your question in binge, feel free to hit that playlist floating shortly above. As always, I've been your host Jack Finch, you've been watching Life's Biggest Questions, and until next time, you take it easy.